Well, it's a new month and a new Oklahoma Sports Scene show. And hello again, everyone. I'm Chris Lincoln.
I'm Grant Merrill. Welcome in to the Hard Rock Casino in Catoosa as Oklahoma Sports Scene presented by the Cherokee Nation. And what a perfect place to have watched March Madness here the Replay Sports Bar on the 51 different big screen TVs. And now you can watch baseball as we kind of do the passing of the torch. So let's see what's happening here at the Hard Rock Casino. The winds of change is upon us. The cash machine is back. So get ready for a whirlwind of winning during Winds of Change at the Hard Rock Hotel and Casino Tulsa. Catch your share of $540,000 cash. Earn entries now and get in on our drawing 6 p.m., 8 p.m., and 10 p.m. on three big Saturdays in April. Drawing winners get to climb inside the cash machine and grab all they can. And don't forget Joe Nichols coming up on April 14th and May 4th as he's a big country star. Of course, Lori Morgan is coming in on May 4th as well as she'll be doing a free concert inside Hard Rock Live. And Three Doors Down coming on July 3rd. Tickets on sale now. And be sure and check in with the Hard Rock Casino in Tulsa. And they'll be getting you hooked up with your tickets to all these great shows.
All right, let's hook you up with our show now. Here's our show lineup to start the month of April. What a lineup we have. Play ball. That's right. It's time for Major League Baseball and Tulsa Driller Baseball to start this week. We have the Drillers manager, Scott Hennessey, just back with a nice tan from Arizona, huh?
Well, yeah, and he does have a tan. It must have been nice to be out there in all that warm weather while we were freezing over here.
He's excited about this Drillers team this year, too.
Speaking of people with a hot career right now, Clay Martin, of course, has been an NFL referee, also the head coach of those white-hot Jenks Trojans, and he'll be joining us to talk a little basketball and football and more basketball with Angie Nelp, head women's coach over at TU.
Just wrapped up the women's championship game, of course, on Sunday night. And gonna wrap some things up with Angie. Look ahead for recruiting and how excited she is about her prospects for TU's next team. And we had a great time with her on the road to Big Fish, Bobby Lane, Major League Fishing Redcrest champion. That was a lot of fun talking with him. He's got a really special bait to show you fishermen, right?
Yeah, absolutely. And everybody's a little in a bit of a better mood when they're $300,000 richer after winning a big tournament on the Grand Lake of the Cherokees.
You'll hear a lot about Major League Fishing with old partner Jim Wilburn and some exciting stuff in fishing. But again, he's going to show you a special crankbait that he won this championship on. So you won't fan fishing. You're going to want to watch this for sure. All right, hot topics. Well, of course, Ralph, the NCAA basketball season, of course, ended on Monday night. What a run it's been. How many great storylines we had from the Peacocks to the Coach K and North Carolina and the Jayhawks. And had a great, 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 great finals.
Absolutely. I'm just glad we won't have to hear Coach K's life story every 20 minutes again. That's just me. I've never been so tired of hearing about somebody in my life. But anyway, that's because I'm an Arkansas fan. Yeah. Kansas, of course, dominating Villanova and KU's 50th NCAA tournament appearance and 16th Final Four appearance as, of course, the Jayhawks went to Monday night's title game versus North Carolina. And how would you like to be North Carolina and have that honor of ending Coach K's career? I mean, North Carolina and Duke have played 100 games.
Isn't that amazing?
It was a 50-50 record for Coach K.
And his first loss as the coach at Duke was to North Carolina.
Yep.
Then he lost his last home game to North Carolina, and then he lost his final game in the Final Four to North Carolina.
Hubert Davis has got to be a coach for life if he wants to be after in his first year taking the Tar Heels to the Final Four and the national championship.
Incredible run. And the basketball is over now. We look ahead to more action. Of course, the NCAA Women's Championship ended on Sunday. And wow, what a downer performance by South Carolina. You don't see a UConn team get pushed around and slapped around like they did, but 64-49. And every time I look, they had a 6'8 girl on the floor, then they bring a 6'7 girl in, a 6'6 girl come in. They were just dominant.
Absolutely. And of course, Gino, a legendary coach up there at UConn, not often you see him lose in that kind of fashion.
11-0 going to that game, championship game.
On such a big stage. 64-49 the final. And of course, after 11 straight wins there. How about the Oklahoma City Thunder announcing a preseason game in Tulsa? They're set to return to the BOK Center Wednesday, October 5th. That's a 7 o'clock tip-off. The matchup will be the Thunder's 13th preseason game in Tulsa. Tickets go on sale this week, 10 a.m. on April 7th. That's a Thursday at BOKCenter.com. So go on ahead and buy yours now. They'll go quick.
I tell you. Yurview Cox Channel is becoming a women's gymnastics school and women's softball school. We're proud of it, too. It's fantastic. For the 18th straight year, the University of Oklahoma's women's gymnastics team is headed to the NCAA championships in Fort Worth, April 14th to the 16th. They're the top seed. They won 12th straight regional title had two near perfect scores, multiple career best, dominated the competition. Minnesota was second, California third. Lady Razorbacks finished fourth in the NCAA there, going to the tournament. And the Sooners coach KJ Kimbler called it an awesome meet. Hope to get her on the show very soon as well.
I don't know if you've ever watched a college gymnastics meet, but there are so many different moving parts in that thing. It's amazing.
Circus. Keep moving. Yeah.
It's amazing as to what all they get under their belt.
And
there,
what great athletes. Wow.
Well, the Tulsa Oilers, near sellout crowds year. We're going to have Andy Skurdo, the owner, on the show here in the next few weeks. But they close out their 21-22 home hockey season. Two dramatic victories, beating Wichita 5-3 last Friday and then overpowering.
Now, the big thing in the Wichita game was our little granddaughter, Lily Stott, sang the national anthem with
her little
kids from Broken Arrow School there. And it would have been nice to turn the mic on. But anyway, they had a good time there. Becky said, we need some tickets for some relatives. 16 tickets. So, thank you, Oilers, for taking care of us there.
Obviously, she got that songbird voice from her grandmother.
Exactly, that's right. And a big, I mean, that was amazing. 10,809 fans were there for the final home game on Saturday night. Then they went down to Allen, Texas, got a point there, so they're right in the heat of this playoff spot, trying to hold on to that fourth spot to make the playoffs.
FC Tulsa continuing their perfect home pitch record with a come-from-behind 3-2 win over the New York Red Bulls this past Saturday night at One Oak Field. J.J. Williams got the tying goal 20 minutes into the match, followed 5 minutes later by Gabby Torres. FC Tulsa with their third goal at the start of the second half on Williams' header for his second home of the night. FC Tulsa now 3-0 at home.
And we're going to play baseball. And Scott Hennessey, the Tulsa Driller's manager, just back from Arizona. Going to fill you all in. You Driller fans want to pay attention. He is really high on this team. Got some great prospects. Major League Baseball guys playing right here in the Tulsa area. So join us for that. Coming up next on Oklahoma Sports Scene, straight ahead.
Get ready for a whirlwind of winning during Winds of Change at Hard Rock Hotel and Casino, Tulsa. Catch your share of $540,000 cash April 16th, 23rd, and 30th in our action-packed money machine at Hard Rock Hotel and Casino, Tulsa. Tulsa's top spot for a good time awaits you. Come experience award-winning entertainment and nightlife. Escape and relax. Savor every bite. Then bring it all in for your encore. Only at Hard Rock Hotel and Casino, Tulsa. Voted Tulsa's best.
It's the crack of the bat and the smell of hot dogs. It's children's laughter and Hornsby dancing. It's the tradition of take me out to the ball game and our state song sung together. It's family time and first dates. It's hugs from friends you haven't seen in a while and high fives from strangers after a Driller's win. It's the fun. It's the tradition. It's the excitement. It's Driller's baseball. It's so much more. Memberships for the 2022 season are on sale now.
At Rogers State University, we keep things personal.
It all starts here.
We make sure our graduates get the most out of their education.
RSU has campuses in Claremore, Bartlesville, and Pryor, with on-campus housing and a wide variety of programs to suit your needs.
It all starts here.
Rogers State University.
The world's fastest athletes are racing live at Remington Park, March 3rd through May 28th. Catch the quarter horse action Thursday through Sunday, March 3rd through May 28th. Enjoy winning racing excitement and jackpot play in the casino. Send your heart racing at Remington Park.
Put the basketballs away, get the bats and balls out, ready to play some baseball. Well, this is Scott Hennessey, manager of the Tulsa Drillers, just back from Arizona in spring training there. That's a nice looking tan you got there. Coach, how many days you spent in the sun there?
I went out there February 6th and just got back Saturday, so like 55 days I was out there, and we had a great time.
You sounded really, really excited about this Drillers team this year.
Correct. We got a lot of guys back, starting with our pitching. You know, Bobby Miller was there for a few starts last year. Right. He'll start in the freeway series on Tuesday night in L.A. and then start our home opener.
For the big club, for the Dodgers?
For the big club. He's going to start that game. And then he's scheduled to pitch our home opener on Tuesday against Amarillo. Michael Grove, who's on the 40-man roster, he'll throw Wednesday, the second day of the series. Starting in Wichita this week, Gus Varland's going to go game one, and Clayton Beter's going to go game two. both high velocity guys, know how to pitch. So, and we have a deep bullpen. So looking forward to it. And guys came out of spring training healthy.
What's the most exciting thing about getting back out of spring training and into that 138 game grind?
Just, you know, getting our guys in our clubhouse, the 28 guys that we're going to have, starting to play series that are meaningful games, and just the grind and guys competing, and they're ready to go. Everybody came out healthy, as I mentioned, and the guys are looking forward to it.
Again, it all begins April the 8th. That's this coming Friday at Wichita for the Drillers. Then they come home April 12th for a six-game series featuring the only doubleheader that'll be set for April the 16th to wrap up that series there. But Scott, again, so much excitement about this baseball team. You three times to a league championship.
Yeah, let's hope it's four.
Yes.
We have, you know, this year we have a lot of really good position players. We have a lot of depth. It's going to be hard to get guys time, but that's my job, to get them time and keep them fresh and keep them sharp. And we have the team to win a championship. But as we all know, this is a great league. Every team has a great team. But we like what we have, and we're ready to get to work.
Well, I know that, you know, the first thing you said to me was, man, you got to get out to the park. It's going to be good this year. Who are some of the names we're going to be hearing about on your squad this year?
Well, we'll have three 40-man guys. And hopefully we won't have them long. But like Jacob Amaya is a returning shortstop. He's made some swing adjustments. We all know he can play defense. And he's went back to more of a line drive approach, and look for him to have a big year. James Outman, another guy on the 40-man roster, he's going to play center field a lot. We'll move him around just to get him some development in right field and left field. Left-hand hitter, has power, can really defend. And Michael Grove, the other guy that's on the 40-man roster, he's made the biggest improvement. You know, he's added a changeup. Breaking ball's gotten better, and he's up to 100 now. So those three guys, we're looking forward to having big years.
What do you see as your early strengths and weaknesses on this roster?
I think, honestly, if I'm shooting you straight, everything we have is going to be a strength.
Wow,
we're going to be able to swing the bat 1 through 9. We have depth, more so than in the years past. We have pitching depth. You know, in the back end, we'll have Guillermo Zuniga, James Hageman, Nick Robertson, Aaron Oshenbein. All those guys are back and much improved. And then our catching, we'll have Hunter Fiducia, who's back. We all know what he can do. He can catch and throw and has offensive ability. And a newcomer, Carson Taylor, who was a draft, 2020 draft, switch-hitting catcher. Fans are going to love him, too.
Now, I went back and I prayed that we could go back to calling it the Texas League.
Yep.
The Lord answered my prayers. So, you know, you've taken your team to a lot of Texas League championships. Is this team, do you feel like they have the potential?
Yeah, I really do. Top to bottom, and we have depth. We have pitching depth. We have, you know, depth on our bench offensively. So it's up to us. It's not going to guarantee us any win. We know the Texas League is tough, and we're ready to get started.
Scott, the 99-day lockout in Major League Baseball, when everything was settled and then all the I's were dotted, T's were crossed, what impact did that have on the minor league players? Any benefits for the minor league system out of that to Major League contract?
Well, we had guys out there early. As I said, I was out there February 6th, and we had guys already out there. We knew that eventually they were going to start spring training games, and our guys were going to have to be ready, and they were ready. But for guys like James Outman, Jacob Amaya, Michael Grove, they were on the 40-man roster. We could not contact them. We didn't know what they were doing, like working out-wise, where they would come in physically ready to go, but they were. They did a good job on their own this offseason. And those three guys, they didn't get there as early as everyone else did. But when they showed up, we got them ramped up. We got their legs under them, and they're ready to go as well.
Any more benefits to these guys in terms of travel or expenses or salaries coming down to that level?
Yeah. This is going to be the first year the club pays for their apartments.
How nice.
And that's really going to help guys out financially. As you know, we have a chef, Chef Rob and Chef Tim.
Unbelievable.
And those guys, this will be their second year in Tulsa. They're fabulous. My wife can attest to that because she has a few of those meals. But the Dodgers have spent a lot of money on nutrition, and it helps keep the guys fresh.
So that's home and away, right? They travel with you?
Yeah, home and away.
Yeah, that's awesome. Yeah.
We got it set up for Wichita, and he's on his way as we speak.
That's great.
Let's talk about the Dodgers a little, because, you know, between what happens here in Tulsa and what happens in Oklahoma City, Oklahoma's kind of become Dodgers country. And what are some of those benefits? How does that trickle down to you besides the financial support?
Well, it's easy for like Andrew Friedman and Brandon Gomes to get to Oklahoma City and then get to Tulsa. You know, if one guy's pitching one night or he wants to see a position player, he'd come to Oklahoma City. Then, if we have Bobby Miller or Michael Grove, it's an hour and a half, hour and 45-minute drive to Tulsa. And, you know, like last year, we had three guys pitching in the big leagues that started the year in Tulsa. Justin Brule, Nunez, and Andre Jackson. And none of those guys were on the 40-man. So they get to come see our guys, and it may help them get to the big leagues if they're doing well quicker.
The home opener, April the 12th. It begins with that series with Amarillo, six-game series, playing a doubleheader on April the 16th. Now we've got to introduce Coach Hennessey's secret weapon. Yeah, come in here. Come on. Let's introduce the new Mrs. Scott Hennessey. Would you tell us right here on the side here? Introduce your bride to us.
Everyone, this is my beautiful wife, Deanne. Horse girl, country girl, and
Oklahoma girl?
Michigan girl.
Oh,
yeah.
Boy.
Very good.
Michigan girl.
Yeah. How'd you end up with a baseball manager?
I ask myself that a lot.
she got through the first year, so we got through the hard part. She did great, so downhill from here.
Well, congratulations.
Congratulations. That's how we do it. We keep Scott here in town. Keep Diane with us, Diamo with us too. So, Kenny, congratulations, Coach.
Thank you.
Looking forward to a great season. Congratulations
you.
For you too. And
Grant,
good to see you. Yes, sir.
And ready
Thank
to play
you.
Ball again out at One Oak Field, April the 12th. Get your season tickets. It's going to be a season to remember. And Scott Hennessey, he's excited about it. He's pumped about it, and so are we. We come back. We're going to switch gears a bit, talk some basketball and some football. The unique guy, Clay Martin, an NFL referee, and a Jenks High School basketball coach. Next on Oklahoma Sports Scene.
Phil defeats Father Time. In May of 2022, the PGA Championship returns to historic Southern Hills Country Club in Tulsa, Oklahoma. Come watch as drama, excitement, and history unfold. Visit pgachampionship.com/2022 for a list of remaining ticket options.
Get ready for a whirlwind of winning during Winds of Change at Hard Rock Hotel and Casino, Tulsa. Catch your share of $540,000 cash April 16th, 23rd, and 30th in our action-packed money machine at Hard Rock Hotel and Casino, Tulsa. Tulsa's top spot for a good time awaits you. Come experience award-winning entertainment and nightlife. Escape and relax. Savor every bite. Then bring it all in for your encore. Only at Hard Rock Hotel and Casino, Tulsa. Voted Tulsa's best.
The Tulsa Oilers are back on the ice. With a new owner, a new look, and a new attitude. Save big on season tickets today. Full season and half season starting as low as $17 per month. Get your season tickets at TulsaOilers.com. TulsaOilers.com. Experience hard-hitting, glove-dropping, pulse-pounding, glass-rattling kind of thrill. Tickets available now at TulsaOilers.com. TulsaOilers.com. This is your town. Your team. Your team. Your Tulsa Oilers are back.
Welcome back to Oklahoma Sports Scene, presented by the Cherokee Nation. Grant Merrill and Chris Lincoln along with you. Always good to have a man of many talents, Clay Martin, joining us, of course, the head basketball coach at Jenks. And many of you saw him on the TV this year as an NFL referee, the white hat, in some of the most important games of the NFL season. Coach, thanks for being with us tonight.
Hey, thanks, guys. It's a joy to be here. Thank you.
I don't know, so Clay's background, I was impressed. So I went all the way back to All-State basketball, football player at Nathan High School, and then went to Oklahoma Baptist University. He's in their Hall of Fame. I know he's in our Tulsa Public Schools Hall of Fame. All well-deserved, Clay. Congratulations.
Well, opinions vary on that, Chris, but I was on some really good teams and had some good coaches and just enjoyed every second at Hale and at OBU.
Well, let's talk about this past basketball season first, the job your Jenks Trojans did, and of course, big news coming out this week, your son Chase, who is a graduating senior, getting named to the Oklahoma Coaches Association All-Star Team. This has been a pretty good year for you guys.
Yeah, we had a really good year, and you know, getting to the state tournament is hard. It's just difficult. 6A basketball is really, really good right now, and to get there was an amazing feeling, and only to be cut short in the quarterfinals. And you know, it's there's only one team smiling at the end, and unfortunately, it wasn't us. But I was really, really proud of our team.
Had to be all proud of your son, Chase. That had to be a real thrill to be able to coach your son. What was that like for you?
You know, it's the last 4 years have flown by. You know, when I came back to coaching, he was in eighth grade, and gosh, it's just flown by, you know, couldn't be prouder, couldn't be happier. Just the type of young man he is, the way he performed, the teammate he is. And I told my wife the other day, I said, gosh, it's just weird right now. I'm walking into off season right now and there's no Chase. There's, you know, I'm used to seeing my guy in the gym every day. But very, very proud of him and many other of our seniors.
What an honor it's been to coach at Jenks, where your athletic department is just excellent in everything. Just talk about the overall picture of things out there and what it's meant to you in these most recent years to be a Trojan.
Well, you nailed it. It's a special place. It starts at the top with our leadership in the central office with Dr. Butterfield and our high school principal, David Byler, and of course, Tony Dillingham, who's been the athletic director for 20 plus years. And they just give you everything you need to try and be successful. We've got unbelievable patrons that live in our district that support us, that raise wonderful kids that we get to work with and coach. It really is a special place, and I consider myself very lucky to have worked there since 03.
And Clay, you're already working towards next season, right? There really is no off season anymore in high school sports.
I'm telling you, yeah. I mean, the state tournament ended on a nice snowy day. If you go back in time, how about that? And yeah. You know, we made it home through the snow and the ice and gave them spring break and another week to relax. And now the weight room is back open, and we're on the court a few days a week, and most of our guys, as you know, are playing on the summer circuits with AAU. So, yeah, it's a grind.
Let's talk some basketball now. Your thoughts on the NCAA tournament, just wrapping up this Monday finally, but some great storylines, some great plays.
It has been awesome to watch. I mean, just as a basketball fan, so many good games. Obviously, the Cinderella story of St. Peter's took me back to cheering on for Oral Roberts last year, and you know, it's just easy to get on board when David is taking on Goliath, and to see them advance that far was just amazing. And I found myself, you know, yelling at the screen and getting excited and those things. But just so many good games that came down to the wire, and it's easy to watch when you're in your lazy boy, and it's a little bit tougher when you're sitting in the chair.
You know, many years ago, a mutual friend of mine and Clay's named Lance Norris tried to get Clay to be a broadcaster, try to join us. Obviously, he went on to bigger and better things, and one of those things has been being an NFL referee, and that's been such an adventure for you, I know. Talk about how you got into that and how that all started for you.
Well, once Lance told me I had a face for radio, I knew I needed to to make some changes, but you know, officiating was just something that kind of friends got me into, mentors got me into, that just, gosh, you've got a background in sports and in football, and you ought to give this a shot. And as a public school teacher, I was always looking to do a little something extra and join the GTOA, and just kind of took off from there, Grant. And it was a fast ride, and a ride that I did not anticipate or expect, but I am so thankful that I've been on that ride and get to do what I do.
Just finishing your fourth season, I believe, right?
Fourth season as a referee, seventh in the NFL. Yeah. So, yeah, I will be starting year eight next year.
What are some of your maybe personal favorites in officiating, some of the things you've enjoyed the most, people you've had a chance to meet and work with?
Yeah, I think you can go to from college football, you know, getting to officiate at Marshall University and be on the square, and with the history of that university and the tragic plane crash, and getting to go to that memorial site and having moments like that, and obviously your first ever NFL game when you get the call there, your first bowl game. I mean, there's so many experiences, Chris, that you look back on, but I think what is common in those are the people you share them with, and your family that's been your support for so many years, the fellow officials that you're in the grind with for so often, you know, so many plays, and you get to celebrate it with them. So there have been some really neat games and moments, but it's still about people, and I've had some really neat people in my life.
You know, we hear all the time about the shortage of officials in high school sports and even college sports. Has that extended at all to the NFL? And are there opportunities for people who may be officiating like you were in the greater Oklahoma area to move up?
I think there's always opportunity to move up. You know, it's how long do you want to grind away at something, right? It doesn't just happen overnight. And mine was about a 10-year process from my first ever whistle to when I got in, and that was considered somewhat fast. I mean, I've got friends who have officiated 20 years that haven't received that call. And so, they're always looking for quality people that just want to give back and serve the game and serve coaches and serve kids. And, you know, that's what it's about. And obviously with each level, the business side of it gets more and more into it and those type things. But, I would recommend the NFL being, an NFL official to anybody. It's a wonderful and challenging job, but it's a job that I'm very thankful and fortunate to be able to do.
Okay, well, what are the toughest calls to make? And then how do you keep control of a game with all these giants running around you?
Well, I just act tough and blow a whistle, Chris. That's all I do, and act like I know what I'm doing. And all the calls are so hard at the professional level. These guys are professionals for a reason. They know the edge. They know what they can do and what they can't do. And everything is just right there. And, for a referee in the backfield, we focus a lot on, probably holding and roughing the passer. And those are very, very difficult to call. So it's hard, but you got to work. You got to look at film. You got to look at your own mistakes. You got to know when you're wrong and how to learn from that and hopefully not make the same one again.
Clay, thanks for taking the time. All the best to Chase and the All-Star Tour. He's going to be on pretty soon. And get a little rest here before you get back into the wild things, basketball and NFL football. Thanks again for joining us.
You
appreciate
bet. Guys, thanks for having me. Thank you. Have a good one.
Thanks, Clay Martin joining us here. We're going to come back with Angie Nelp, the TU Women's head basketball coach, straight ahead.
Phil defeats Father Time. In May of 2022, the PGA Championship returns to historic Southern Hills Country Club in Tulsa, Oklahoma. Come watch as drama, excitement, and history unfold. Visit pgachampionship.com/2022 for a list of remaining ticket options.
Josie's on a vacation far away. Come around and talk it over.
Times may change, but the feeling stays the same.
Stay and never keep it under.
Greatest hits at Hard Rock Hotel and Casino, Tulsa.
The Tulsa Oilers are back on the ice. With a new owner, a new look, and a new attitude. Save big on season tickets today. Full season and half season starting as low as $17 per month. Get your season tickets at TulsaOilers.com. TulsaOilers.com. Experience hard-hitting, glove-dropping, pulse-pounding, glass-rattling kind of thrill. Tickets available now at TulsaOilers.com. TulsaOilers.com. This is your town. Your team, your Tulsa Oilers are back.
Well, the 2021-22 women's college basketball season ended on Sunday night in Minneapolis with a beatdown by South Carolina over at UConn. And joining us now is Angie Nelp, the head basketball coach of the University of Tulsa women's team. And we last talked to you after a 10-0 start. Congrats on a great winning season and going to the tournament, and well done.
Oh, thank you. Girls worked extremely hard. Super proud of the team this year for everything that they worked really hard to accomplish, and so excited for that. We had a great year.
Yeah.
What was your favorite part of it?
Oh my goodness, there were so many favorite parts. And that was really the great thing about this year is, a lot of history was made at the University of Tulsa. And first and foremost, credit to these young women. All the credit goes to our team and our players who just worked incredibly hard. There were lots of water, water celebrations in the locker room, and each one of those were definitely special. I mean, there were just these turning points, throughout the season. We won two non-conference tournaments. We won one out in Florida, and We won one out in Georgia, and those were really big, you know, back-to-back games for our teams to be able to do that, and then heading into conference play and, you know, getting our win against Wichita State on senior night and then again in the tournament was very special and helped prepare us, you know, for our postseason win, you know, at UNT. So all of them probably special in their own way, maybe a little bit of a longer answer than what you wanted, but it was definitely a special year with this group.
The Golden Hurricane had not had a 17-game winning season in women's basketball since 2014. That really excited the fan base, too. Got people coming out to women's basketball.
It did. You know, our crowd, you know, it made such a difference for us. There was a moment, you know, after some of our games where our players were like, man, we really felt the energy. We really felt the support, you know, of those people that came to our games and the support in the community and those that watched, you know, on TV. It meant a lot to our team, and it was a big difference in our success.
Have you had your blood pressure checked since that triple overtime game?
Oh,
in Wyoming?
My goodness.
Tough loss at Wyoming, huh?
Yeah, you know, that game, you ask me, you know, which one, you know, I'm most proud of. It may be that moment where, you know, we're on the road in just such a tough environment and we're facing just a lot of adversity and just going in, and the amount of just fight and toughness that our team showed in that game, in all the overtimes that we played. You know, obviously it didn't come out, you know, the result wasn't what we wanted, but I'm just so proud of them for their fight. And I did not check my blood pressure. I think I need to not do that after that triple overtime, but man, those girls left absolutely everything that they had out on that court every time.
And that was more history. No women's basketball team in Tulsa had ever gone to three overtimes, right?
Really?
First time ever.
Okay,
time. More history for Angie and Nelp.
Let's win in regulation. Let's
He's been around for most of them.
What did you learn as the first year coach of the TU women's basketball team? What were some things you learned?
Yeah, well, how long's the show? Because I had, you know, just such great leadership at TU that really, you know, I was able to come in and learn from, you know, our administration and how supportive they are of our women's basketball team. I think the most fun part was just learning about the players and who they are as people. Yeah. You know, you guys get to see them out and perform on the court, and just knowing who they are as young women, you know, in the classroom and as students, and then as people and the way that they give back in community service, like just getting to know them as people and starting to build those relationships was really special this year.
You know, I've seen some of your girls on social media. I've seen some of them that are just so glad to be coming back to Tulsa. And in this era of everybody going to the transfer portal and you never know who's going to be back, I mean, that's got to feel really good to you.
It does. You know, Maya Mayberry and Maddie Biddle have chosen to take their fifth year and stay with us. And their leadership is something, you know, that we're going to definitely value on this team next year. And not just that, I mean, they're incredible players. You know, being able to have that returning to us is going to be huge.
What are the prospects now? We're already talking about 22-23.
Yeah.
And you're already practicing.
We are. We are in our postseason and our spring workouts that we get to have. And so, you know, it definitely is a celebrated year for sure. You know, and everything that those players gave all year is exciting and celebrated and really built the foundation for the future of TU women's basketball. And so we are starting to turn that page and start practicing a little bit with our team next year. And I'm really excited about where our team is going.
I know that in our first visit earlier in the season, we talked a lot about the recruiting, and we talked about the fact that you wanted to recruit Oklahoma girls and bring them to Tulsa. How's that going for you, and what needs are you trying to fill while you're recruiting?
Yeah, it's going well. I am so excited to recruit here in our footprint, to recruit here in Oklahoma. There is such great homegrown talent. You know, we're working really hard to make sure that our players, you know, here in the state of Oklahoma stay home and play here at home. And so I think they have a great opportunity here with our program and in our vision of where our program is going, and help building that is, you know, a lot of this area and the talent that is here and in our footprint too. And so, you know, I don't know if did y'all go to the state championship games?
I knew
you would be. You don't miss them. No, I knew you would be there. But
especially.
But you go to those, and they're some of the best in the country. You know, they're some of the best in the nation and some of the best competitors, you know, out at those tournaments. And so really excited about, you know, the future of basketball here in Oklahoma for TU women's basketball.
I know we tried to get Coach Nelp on the show last week. Chris, I'd like to be with you, but I'm going to be at a young lady's house at post play. I'm trying to recruit, so that was much more important. So recruiting, of course, is the lifeblood of things.
Thank you for being flexible with me on that.
That's more important than this, for sure. So, what do you feel your needs are? What would you like to add to this team?
Yeah, well, with our 2022 class, we do have five incoming players where we tried to add just some size and some versatility to our team, which we were able to do. And we're looking forward kind of in that next class to go a little bit that same direction, you know, versatility and our style of play that we play with, you know, having kind of positionless basketball is really key. We're going to look to kind of gear more towards some ball handling guards in that class and definitely some playmakers because we felt like we got a lot of that versatility and size in this next class coming in.
You know, one thing that has been on the agenda lately is that it's kind of a new day for TU. You guys are trying to fill seats in the arena for both the men's and women's basketball games. Coach Conkle has come in. You've gotten a chance to meet him. It looks like in your first year and with him incoming that the future's never been brighter for TU basketball on both sides.
Well, there's a lot of energy and enthusiasm, that's for sure. You know, I've had the opportunity to visit with Coach Conkle and his wife Megan and his family, and we're just so excited to welcome them to TU, and I really think he's going to do some really great things. And so we're excited that, you know, the landscape of basketball at the University of Tulsa is on the rise.
I know you and your young ladies have obviously followed the women's NCAA tournament as well. Mm-hmm. And when you see teams like South Carolina and Connecticut and the bar set so high, how the young ladies react to that, it's got to be a great challenge. That's what you got to get to.
Yeah, it is. You know, what's amazing is how many text messages, you know, our girls were all watching the games and they're all texting saying, you know, we can be there. And they believe it. And believing is that first step. It takes a lot of work and we have a long ways to go and a lot of work ahead of us to do. But when you have young women who believe in each other and want to play for each other and want to come in and go to work every single day for that dream, anything can happen.
This was your first year looking around the conference. Who were some of your natural rivals that kind of developed?
Right. Well, I think everybody's a rival. You know, that's one thing I love about our conference is there's no nights off. You know, it's so competitive. It's one of the premier conferences in the country. And every night you have to show up and you have to be your best. And so I feel like maybe we developed rivalries with everybody, you know, along the way. I felt like we were right there in most of our games. And so I'm excited about our conference. I'm excited about where we can compete this next year.
I don't suppose you miss UConn leaving the conference.
I know. It definitely changed the conference a little bit. Excited, you know, for UConn and their success and obviously everything they have. But I still think we have a very high talent level within our conference with our teams.
Have you started working? Or probably it's already set. How far are you into setting the 22-23 women's basketball schedule for TU?
Yeah, we're still in the process of setting that schedule. Right. You know, there's a lot that goes into it, especially with all the conference changes, you know, that are happening. You have to kind of look ahead a little bit with those things of who can play and who can't play and what that travel may look like. But we're excited to have a competitive schedule this next year.
You know, I was talking to my wife who's a high school coach, and we were just talking about you and your schedule and the fact that you're juggling all of this with being a mom. You've got three
littles?
We have four.
Yes. So you guys know I have the most amazing husband ever, Jake. He is my rock, and he, you know, he has so much support for what we do. But you know, I really like to think of it as our family life is really merged with our jobs. You can't really keep them separate. You know, everybody talks about balance. We just talk about merging. You know, my kids are, you know, they're going to school and they're growing up. You know, at TU Gymnasium. So it's definitely a blessing to be able to have my family and the support that we have.
Well, Angie came off the court, rushed out here to the Hard Rock Casino to be with us here on a Monday evening for TV. We have something for you, Angie, to thank you to come and enjoy this high-end breakfast at Hatch.
Well,
I'm an official greeter in the morning.
Okay, I need to come.
I'll be there at
for
6
sure.
We'll see you at 6 in the morning.
Oh,
Angie.
6 a.m. I'm up. Trust me. Our littlest one is awake, and he'll be with me. So
I was about to say,
you.
Two of the four are already up by then, I'm sure.
Yes, so. Yes, thank you.
And you TU fans, this is your opportunity to get involved with Coach Angie Nelp. With Coach Conkle, of course, a new men's coach. Let's support TU basketball. Get out there and make a difference here. It does make a difference, doesn't it, Coach?
It absolutely does.
We're going to come back and talk to another champion bass fisherman. Straight ahead, it's the Big Fish Bobby Lane next.
It's the crack of the bat and the smell of hot dogs. It's children's laughter and Hornsby dancing. It's the tradition of take me out to the ball game and our state song sung together. It's family time and first dates. It's hugs from friends you haven't seen in a while and high fives from strangers after a driller's win. It's the fun. It's the tradition. It's the excitement. It's driller's baseball. It's so much more. Memberships for the 2022 season are on sale now.
Get ready for a whirlwind of winning during Winds of Change at Hard Rock Hotel and Casino, Tulsa. Catch your share of $540,000 cash April 16th, 23rd, and 30th in our action-packed money machine at Hard Rock Hotel and Casino, Tulsa. Tulsa's top spot for a good time awaits you. Come experience award-winning entertainment and nightlife. Escape and relax. Savor every bite. Then bring it all in for your encore. Only at Hard Rock Hotel and Casino, Tulsa. Voted Tulsa's best.
At Roger State University, we keep things personal.
It all starts here.
We make sure our graduates get the most out of their education.
RSU has campuses in Claremore, Bartlesville, and Pryor, with on-campus housing and a wide variety of programs to suit your needs.
It all starts here.
Roger State University.
We welcome you back to Oklahoma Sports Scene. It's time to hit the lake as, of course, talking a little fishing here. Is joining us from on the road, headed to East Texas, is Big Fish Bobby Lane. He's the new 2022 Major League Fishing Redcrest Tournament winner. Bobby, how are you today?
Guys, I'm wonderful. I'm actually heading out to Palestine, Texas for our next event, which is Heavy Hitters. Practice begins on Thursday, but I thought the whirlwind was going to slow down a little bit, but it seems like it just continues to whirl around, and I am loving every minute of it, man.
Well, what a dramatic finish for the Redcrest Tournament. Talk about that. I mean, it came right down to the last fish in that boat just before time went off. Recap that finish for us.
Yeah, what an amazing third period it was. You know, I caught a 3-pound, 10-ounce bass, and then I caught a 6-3 behind some docks, and I had an hour and 15 minutes to go, and I knew where I wanted to get to, and I just hope I had enough time to do it. Caught another couple of 2-pounders, and then right at the end, with 2.5 minutes to go, I had already weighed the fish once, and it weighed 115. In Major League Fishing rules, the fish had to weigh 2 pounds on Grand Lake that week to be a scoreable bass, and I re-weighted again, and it weighed 115. And somehow, some way, shape, or form, I reweighed that fish the third and final time, and it went 2-1 and then dropped to 2 pounds even, and they crowned Bobby Lane the Redcrest champion. So, you know, it was meant to be. I've had them go the other way so many times, but I'm reliving that, and I've watched it hundreds of times, and it's never going to get old, man. What an awesome week it was. So glad to be in Tulsa that week and Grand Lake of the Cherokees. The bass were big and plentiful and healthy for sure.
Now, you live in Florida. You get to fish all over the place. And I know around Oklahoma, Arkansas, East Texas, there's a lot of pretty good fish. What are some of your favorite lakes to get on?
So right now, my favorite lake in the world is Grand Lake of the Cherokees, for sure.
You have 300,000 reasons why.
Yeah, I have to say that was that's a easy answer for me right now. But you know, I really love the I'm down from Lake Kissimmee, Orlando area, and those are right in my backyard. Lake Harris, Lake Okeechobee. You know, I really loved fishing grass lakes like Lake Potomac and some of the lakes up north. But man, the more I'm getting into this and furthering in my career, I'm starting to like the lakes with a little bit of rock in them. And Grand Lake of the Cherokees, you know, is one of them. We're going to the Ozarks here in a couple of weeks. I'm really starting to love those kind of lakes. They've become easier as the more I go on and have some real beautiful quality fish in them for sure.
You're listening to Big Fish Bobby Lane. He's in his Toyota truck, but he's parked as he's getting ready to head to Texas for another tournament here. Bobby, tell us something about this. Major League Fishing. My old partner in winter communication, Jim Wilburn, is a guy that's very much in part of this. I'm sure you know Jim, and what a great job they've done with this series. How much impact has this had on your sport?
Yeah, man. You know, we made a lot of us made a change about 4 or 5 years ago. We decided to join Major League Fishing, and of course, run by Jim Wilburn, Boyd Duckett, Gary Klein, Don Rux, those guys, yeah. And Jim has been a huge inspiration in all of this. You know, he's the brains behind all of it, man. He's the reason we have the sponsors that we do. He's the reason we have the payout that we do. And he's been amazing since day one. And they call him the shark for a reason. You know, he never He never lets down from a fight. He always wants a little bit more, and that's the kind of guy you want on your side for sure. You know, Jim has been, he had a vision a long time ago. We started the cup events, you know, 10, 11 years ago, and now we got a team series out there. We got the Bass Pro Tour, and they purchased the FLW side of it. Now it's the Tackle Warehouse Pro Circuit, and I'm fishing that also. So he's been a huge impact in my career. He's given me an opportunity to fish for 1 pound fish. He's given me an opportunity to fish for 5 fish limit, and of course the Bass Pro Tour. And let me tell you, the scene at Tulsa, there at the griller, it actually had my truck and boat wrap on it, the Durabraid truck and boat, which is a new spider wire that's come out. And to have my family there, to have that huge crowd, the dinners were beautiful, the evenings, the gifting suite, I mean, it really made us feel like something special that week. So kudos to Jim, man. He was the reason all this went down.
And he does it first pass all the way. I heard there was, what, helicopters involved getting you off Grand Lake and into the Tulsa weigh-in stuff, and then also limousines. Tell us about the weekend.
Yep, so we there were some insurance issues with the helicopters, and not many of the anglers, including myself, wanted to get in a helicopter and fly back to the expo there. So right. He arranged limos, and I must say, I was fixing to bring that up. To be police escorted in a limo down, I guess that's 44?
Yeah,
west
44.
To Tulsa from Grand Lake. I drove it every morning in my Toyota, and it was a long drive. But let me tell you, being police escorted in a limo, it felt like we made it back in no time at all. To come out of that limo in front of the paparazzi, it felt like, to feel like a rock star, man. He made it super special for me, and made it special for all of us that were in the top 20. We all got to ride in that limo. We had food, we had drinks. The driver was super cool. I mean, it was the chance of a lifetime to be in a top 10, and to have that opportunity to be in that limo, to be crowned the champion in front of a big stage. It was exactly what I dreamed about when I was a little kid, of winning something like this for sure. Right.
You know, there's a lot of guys watching who are probably thinking, I'm a pretty good fisherman. Yeah. I want to get into this. I mean, what are the first steps that people need to take if they want to head toward a career like yours?
Well, I'm kind of old school, so some of these guys might want to hear this, but I always say, let your fish do the talking, man. You got in this because you love the outdoors and you love to catch bass. And I get so many times I get asked from kids in high school and even college, you know, what do I do about sponsorship? And my answer to that is, number one, be really good on social media. You know, post a lot, make good posts, nothing negative. You know, confrontation is often, there's nothing wrong with confrontation as long as it's positive confrontation. But, you know, you're a bass fisherman, so let your fish do the talking. The more fish you catch, the more time your name's going to be up on top of the leaderboard, and that's what's going to attract sponsors. Of course, they want somebody great on, you know, selling their product, but they also want them to catch fish. So if you're good at both of those, man, you got a long career in this. But my first and number one recommendation to anybody listening that wants to become a bass fisherman is put the fish on the scale, or weigh them the way we do at Major League Fishing, or a weigh-in, and let your fish do the talking. That's what we do this for, is because we truly love the sport of bass fishing.
Big Fish Bobby Lane with us, the Redcrest Tournament winner, $300,000 winner. Before we let you go, Bobby, just for the average fisher, what tips might you have for guys that want to give them a chance to catch a few more fish? What are some of your big tips?
Yeah, man. You know, I'm sponsored by a wonderful company, Pure Fishing. They own Berkeley. They own Spider Wire. I mean, Abu Garcia, they own it all. This little bait right here, I got it hanging on my mirror. It's pretty simple. This is the Fritz Side 5. It's brown HD crawl is what I caught 99% of my fish on. Really? If you're looking for a early spring pre-spawn bite, you simply take this bait, put it on a crank, Abu Garcia crank and rod and reel with 12-pound fluorocarbon. Go crank some shallow rock. You're going to have a lot of success. And then, of course, as the year moves on, you know, you need to get into your plastics. They're going to start hitting the bank a little bit. Top water, spinner bait, stuff like that. But you know, I like to keep it real. Of course, we got the new thing out. It's called forward-facing sonar. Mine is Lowrance, Active Target. that is a huge thing. You need to learn as much as you can about your electronics anymore. But this little tech, this little guy right here, this HD Crawl Fritz Side 5, HD Brown, did all of my damage just cranking shallow rock. And it is still a key player right now in a lot of places. So they got them everywhere, but Berkeley has really stepped up the game in the hard bait side of things lately and came off with an awesome win this week. So my hat's off to them for coming out with an awesome bait that caught a lot of big fish.
Bobby, my old partner Jim Wilbur would not forgive me if I didn't get a TV plug in here. The coverage of Redcrest 2022 will be showcased across a two-hour episode, premiering at 6 a.m. Fishermen are up by then. July 2nd and July 9th on the Discovery Channel in a one-hour special episode of MLF. Redcrest 22 will premiere at 2 p.m. Eastern Sunday, July 17th on no less than the CBS network. Jim Wilburn thinks big, does big, and so is this big bass man right here. Again, Bobby Lane, thanks for pulling over on the way to Texas to spend a little time with us on Oklahoma Sports Scene. Congratulations on taking $300,000 of our money out of Grand Lake.
Thank you guys for having me on. It's been, and I promise you, I'm going to be up in July early that morning watching that show on CBS. I can't wait. Thanks you guys.
Again.
Enjoy your show, and hopefully we catch some big ones out there and heavy hitters.
Be safe. Thank you. Big Fish Bobby Lane. We're going to come back with our Remington Race Report, some Kentucky Derby prep races to show you right after this.
The Tulsa Oilers are back on the ice.
With a new owner, a new look, and a new attitude. Save big on season tickets today. Full season and half season starting as low as $17 per month. Get your season tickets at TulsaOilers.com.
TulsaOilers.com.
Experience heart-hitting, glove-dropping, pulse-pounding, glass-rattling kind of thrill. Tickets available now at TulsaOilers.com.
TulsaOilers.com.
This is your town.
Your town.
Your team.
Your team.
Your Tulsa Oilers are back.
It's the crack of the bat and the smell of hot dogs. It's children's laughter and Hornsby dancing. It's the tradition of take me out to the ball game and our state song sung together. It's family time and first dates. It's hugs from friends you haven't seen in a while and high fives from strangers after a driller's win. It's the fun. It's the tradition. It's the excitement. It's driller's baseball. It's so much more. Memberships for the 2022 season are on sale now.
Jules is on a vacation far away. Come around and talk it over.
Times may change, you know, but the feeling stays the same.
Stay alive and keep it undercover. I just want to use your love tonight. Oh, I don't want to
live your greatest hits at Hard Rock Hotel and Casino, Tulsa.
Sweet. Also on the spotlight, a defending AQHA distance champion. Here's our man Dale Day, trackside.
Last week, we brought you the story of Shockingly Famous, who successfully expanded his racing repertoire to move around the turn in 870 yards. This week, he had a really big test in a stakes event around the turn, facing the current AQHA distance champion. The Grade 2 Paul's Valley Stakes was the stage, as 2021 American Quarter Horse Association distance champion Wascally Whittle Wabbit faced five others around the turn, including successful newcomer to the distance in Shockingly Famous.
They're off in the Paul's Valley Stakes. Quick start inside. Wascally Whittle Wabbit goes for the front, thereby half length. Holy Storm and Shockingly Famous moving together now as they reach the turn. Fourth there, three and a half back with three furlongs to go. Bubba Bad beginning to advance. Gap of four to Ubly, I'll Fly V. And then very back, 10 lengths off of it, is Pete's Favorite. Quarter mile to go, and the champion will show the way to the top of the stretch first, hugging that rail. Wascally Whittle Wabbit on top by a pair. Here comes Shockingly Famous in second. Holy Storm chasing third inside. Bubba Bad floating out and is a wide fourth inside the furlong pole. Wascally Whittle Wabbit now being asked a bit by Romero. Is out by three. Shockingly Famous chasing. Wascally Whittle Wabbit debuts in 2022. A winner, the champion, wins it by three in the Paul's Valley.
Shockingly Famous was game, but the current distance champ had too much in the stretch. Wascally Whittle Wabbit wins the Paul's Valley Stakes for the second straight year. This pair is primed to face each other again later in the season on Champions Night, May 28th, in the Remington Park Distance Championship.
They're off.
Veteran Oklahoma Reds faced each other in the Mr. Jetmore Stakes on the final day of March. Charlie's Fury used a great start and enjoyed the 350-yard distance in turning the tables on J.C. Wild King, who previously won the Mighty Deck 3 Stakes on opening weekend.
Charlie's Fury to the inside. Charlie's Fury takes the Mr. Jetmore.
Big race night coming up on April 16th, the $973,000 Remington Park Futurity and the $270,000 Remington Park Derby leading the way. Extreme Race Day with the Camels, Ostriches, Zebras, and more falls on Sunday, April 24th. Live Racing Weekly, Thursday through Sunday, 6 p.m. start time, except on Sunday when we race at 4 p.m. At Remington Park in Oklahoma City, I'm Dale Day. Now back to Sportscene.
There were two big Kentucky Derby prep races this past week. Upset in the grade $1.25 million Arkansas Derby at Oaklawn, won by Cyber Knife, trained by Brad Cox. Cyber Knife won by 2 3/4 lengths, followed by Barber Road, and then the 7-5 race favorite, the filly Secret Oath, trained by Hall of Fame trainer D-Wayne Lucas. The filly finished third. Lucas, after the race, said he would point her towards the Kentucky Oaks. Expect, though, Cyber Knife to be heading for Churchill Downs and the run for the Roses. Then in the $1 million Florida Derby down at Gulfstream Park in South Florida, White Abrero won over Charge It. Next Saturday, by the way, April the 9th, is the last big weekend of Kentucky Derby prep races. It features the Wood Memorial at Aqueduct Racetrack, the Bluegrass Stakes at historic Keeneland Racecourse in Lexington, Kentucky, and the Santa Anita Derby at Santa Anita Park in California. So big racing coming up as we get down the stretch towards the Kentucky Derby the first Saturday in May. Next, I have a tribute to a very special Tulsa icon.
Get ready for a whirlwind of winning during Winds of Change at Hard Rock Hotel and Casino, Tulsa. Catch your share of $540,000 cash April 16th, 23rd, and 30th in our action-packed money machine at Hard Rock Hotel and Casino, Tulsa. Tulsa's top spot for a good time awaits you. Come experience award-winning entertainment and nightlife. Escape and relax. Savor every bite. Then bring it all in for your encore. Only at Hard Rock Hotel and Casino, Tulsa. Voted Tulsa's best.
The Tulsa Oilers are back on the ice. With a new owner, a new look, and a new attitude. Save big on season tickets today. Full season and half season starting as low as $17 per month. Get your season tickets at TulsaOilers.com. TulsaOilers.com. Experience hard-hitting, glove-dropping, pulse-pounding, glass-rattling kind of thrill. Tickets available now at TulsaOilers.com. TulsaOilers.com. This is your town. Your town. Your team. Your team. Your Tulsa Oilers are back.
The world's fastest athletes are racing live at Remington Park, March 3rd through May 28th. Catch the quarter horse action Thursday through Sunday, March 3rd through May 28th. Enjoy winning racing excitement and jackpot play in the casino. Send your heart racing at Remington Park.
You're looking at Julius Pegues. He is a true Tulsa civic icon in the black community, an outstanding Booker T. Washington High School basketball legend. He passed away on March the 29th at age 86. He went from Booker T. Washington to the University of Pittsburgh as the first African-American basketball player ever to play for the Pitt Panthers. While he was at school, he also earned an engineering degree. Most recently, Pegues worked to memorialize Tulsa's 1921 race massacre. Julius Pegues and his incredible wife, Wynette, travel with us and will always certainly be missed. But remember, for all he did for the city of Tulsa, the state of Oklahoma, Julius Pegues, the true Tulsa icon.
What a tremendous loss. He surely
great,
will
great
be
person.
Missed.
Yep.
Well, don't forget to join us on Oklahoma Sports Scene. We're on Wednesdays and Friday nights at 10:30, Saturday nights at 11 on Cox Yurview Channel 3 and online on YouTube. Just search for Oklahoma Sports Scene.
Going to have the owner of the Tulsa Oilers, Andy Smart, is going to be back with us to talk about what's happened this season. Look, Andy's got some big, big plans, including he's going to build some ice rinks in Tulsa.
Apparently so. There's a lot of rumors going around, and we'll sort out what's what with Andy. He's a
good
guy
good.
For sure. So be sure to join us. Thanks for being with us tonight.